Hey there, Boulevard family, and happy Sunday. We pray that you have been blessed by this morning's worship experience. Now let's get you right into your Boulevard Blitz. Boulevard family, join us as we wrap up our celebration of Black history. Each Sunday this month, we have had a different theme and attire. February 25th is Heritage Sunday, so come dress in your African attire. Join the celebration at either our 9 a.m. or 11 a.m. service. The Draw the Circle 40 Days of Prayer Challenge is underway. Books for this challenge will be available for purchase at the reception desk. We look forward to coming together in prayer and reflection during the sacred season. If you are a Boulevard High School senior or an interested adult scholar, don't miss the 2024 MBCC Youth and Adult Scholarship Application Process. For helpful information on eligibility, requirements, and the application submission process, email Minister Chris Watson at watson.christopher@theboulevard.org. The deadline for applications is March 31st. Attention Boulevard couple celebrating anniversaries in February. Share a photo and the number of years you have been married to media@theboulevard.org. Today is the deadline. We will celebrate love with you on next Sunday. To stay up to date on all Boulevard events, follow us on social media, download the Boulevard app with notifications turned on, and sign up for our monthly e-news by emailing info@theboulevard.org. Don't miss out on what's happening at the Boulevard. That's it for this week's Boulevard Blitz. We pray each of you have a blessed week, and we will see you next Sunday for Heritage Sunday. Don't forget to wear your African attire. We will leave you today with a brief Black history fact. Today, we observed Achievement Sunday and paid tribute to HBCUs. In today's Black History feature, we'll explore the importance of HBCUs in the Black community. Here are some intriguing facts that you may not be aware of. Cheney University of Pennsylvania was the first HBCU established, and Lincoln University in Oxford, which opened in 1954, was the first degree-granting HBCU. HBCUs make up only 3% of colleges and universities in the U.S. Alabama is home to 14 HBCUs, more than any state in the country. North Carolina has the most students enrolled in HBCUs than any other state. Half of Black public school teachers in the U.S. attended an HBCU. Most HBCUs are located in the South or on the East Coast. Tuskegee University in Tuskegee, Alabama, was the first HBCU to be registered as a National Historic Landmark and the only HBCU to be a National Historic Site. 80% of Black judges graduated from HBCUs. The majority of the first HBCUs in the U.S. were created to train Black Americans to become teachers and preachers. Today, approximately 300,000 students are enrolled in over 100 HBCUs across the country. Yet, as aforementioned, HBCUs only make up 3% of degree-granting institutions in the U.S. The pivotal role of HBCUs in offering transformative opportunities for Black Americans cannot be overstated. These institutions remain foundational in fostering the education and success of Black students who often encounter systemic barriers and marginalization within mainstream higher education settings. Despite their undeniable significance, HBCUs face numerous challenges, including chronic underfunding and constrained avenues for growth and development. This financial strain limits their ability to expand programs, update infrastructure, and compete with better resourced institutions. However, recent strides have been made to address these disparities. A notable increase in federal funding signals a positive step towards alleviating financial burdens and bolstering the resources available to HBCUs. In essence, while HBCUs face persistent challenges, Their resilience and commitment to serving Black communities remain unwavering. The recent infusion of federal funding signifies a promising stride towards ensuring the sustainability and continued impact of these invaluable institutions in shaping the future of Black education and empowerment.